There we go. Thank you for forgetting that this thing is on. My bad. Okay. Okay. I'll be ready in about a few minutes. I just need to do a couple of things. Size gigantic, heavens. Hold on. Thank you. Good golly Molly. Your size does not need to be that big. Oh, good God. Okay, it is officially 3:30. It's best we begin. Let me turn down the city pop funk. Let me turn down the city punk stuff. My ears, rather, so I can hear myself a little better. Okay. Let's transition. Oh, actually, I need to make sure that my stream is doing okay. How are you, stream? How are you, stream? Are you okay, my stream? You okay, my stream? Now it's the stream. Gosh darn. Ah, here we go. Okay, just making sure that my stream is okay. Seems to be live, which is good. Okay. There we go. I'm gonna win then. Okay, that's just a BGM for now. Okay. It looks like we're good. Yeah, I think we're good. Alright. So, hello everyone. Welcome to Manga Drawing Lessons Weekly. Used to be Manga Drawing Lessons Live, and it used to be Manga Drawing Lessons, period. When it was just IRL, but this is where we are right now. My name is Paolo Jassa, and I am the teen librarian of the Govins branch of the Enoch Pratt Free Library. This program is brought to you by the Enoch Pratt Free Library of Baltimore City in Maryland. Anyway, and essentially, this program is how to learn how to draw anime and manga characters step by step in weekly sessions. This is also partly a take in me, and if you pass by the Govins branch address here in Baltimore, Maryland, you can pick up a binder with materials to sketch and like really nice paper. Just a kind of like insider baseball thing. The paper we use is the HP Premium 32-pound paper, which is really smooth and really great at holding on inks and papers and everything, and doesn't bleed as much as like copier paper does. And Lord knows copier paper bleeds a lot. Ugh, it's kind of gross. Anyway. Alright, so. Sorry, just adjusting the levels, literally the levels inside my headset. Anyway, so today we are going to continue learning how to draw various anime manga style things. Just to let you know, all of our lessons are going to be here in this Google Drive. under my name. Let's put that away, shall we? Under my Pratt Library address. I think it's tinyurl.com/manga drawing lessons. Yes? Hold on. Oh, please. It should be that. I can't get to it right now. Yeah, no, it should be that. Anyway. So, last week we went on a kind of a short, like, how-to guide to draw in proportion. And this was the lesson three, where we were talking about how to do proportions, tips and tricks and stuff. And we even drew a bit in Clip Studio Paint. By the way, you don't have to do this all digitally. You can also do this on paper, on an iPad, what have you, so long as you can draw it. Anyway, we talked about how to do proportions, how, like, if you stretch those proportions, they'll make a character look taller or shorter, etc., etc. And then the main differences were, like, or rather, the main differences were, main examples would be, like, Clamp anime and manga, like, Holic or XXX Holic and Cardcaptor Sakura versus, like, anything made by Akira Toriyama, like Dragon Ball Z, which characters tend to be, like, short stacks, which is really, really fun and cute. But speaking of short stacks, we're gonna transition back, and I'm gonna transition back. What's it called? The next part supposedly was, oh, how to draw adults, and essentially it's like make sure their stature is dependent on their age, what's it called? They have the different eyes, add wrinkles under face, and how to draw chunkier characters, which this is correct to a certain extent, although different types of fat hangs off of bodies in different ways depending on your figure. This is certainly one way to go about it, but some days it can look totally different. And of course, babies and toddlers, that's how to draw them. Basically, they're tiny, tiny human beings. But speaking of tiny human beings, we're gonna go over to the next one because I really, really want to do this lesson. It's the most fun. Or rather, going over this lesson is the most fun. There we go. So, in the book, which I have here, so the book we're using is Mastering Manga with Mark Crowley. There are several copies available, one of which I'm holding in my hand right now. In the library, he has one. Let me very quickly check. Hold on. I know he's got others. Yeah, so the next one is called Mastering Manga 2, Level Up with Mark Crowley. Which is basically more of the same, but like more, like on a different level, because it's the, what's it called? Oh, you can buy 1, 2, and 3. Yay! Only for under $50. Nice. And number 3 would be Master Skills, Step Demonstrations, etc., etc. Obviously, you don't have to go 1, 2, 3, but it does help. I think he expands on the lessons that he has in the first one, in the next one, and the following one. All three should be available in the Enoch Pratt Free Library. In fact, all three should be available in the Goblin's Branch, but I think someone borrowed my copy. Or rather, the branch's copy, I should say. I need to find that and put that on hold, because I kind of want to continue with the same author so that the style is consistent in terms of how we're going to learn how to draw. It's good to, like, When you're learning a specific person's design and style and how to draw stuff in their style, just to be like, oh, so this is how to do that, and this is how to do that. And then once you're done, move on to the next person or a different person, so that you can kind of expand your visual, what's called visual library of how things look and how things don't look, etc., etc. It's really, really useful and highly recommend it. In fact, let me go ahead and put up the... there's this great extension on Chrome which shows me exactly... Oh, it's called the... See, there was one. It is checked out. I was right. I can show you. Oh, the other one is also checked out. Where is it? I want it. So these, this is the catalog of the Enoch Bradfrey Library. And this, and like, put in your library card and your PIN number, and you'll be able to borrow this book, as well as many others. But has he written other things? I feel like he has. Let's check the personal author. Yes, he's written... Ah, la 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 la. Put link in tab. There it is. Alright. Oh no, we're looking for permanent link. Permanent link. Voila. Alright. There we go. So he has more. Building like a ghost book. I did not know that. Pocket size Akiko. That's nice. Oh, that's cute. Anyway, so you can borrow this book, and this book in the Enoch Bradfrey Library, and highly recommend you do so that you can have like an entire set of like, oh, this is how to draw in this person's style, etc., etc. And on that note, we're gonna go back to the lesson that that we're gonna talk about here. It would be page 66. Okay, sorry, I think my microphone just decided to die for a second. Ugh, my bad. Anyway, so, just like on screen, we're gonna learn how to draw chibis today, and it's gonna be fun. So, oh, digital dragons. Oh, he also, oh no, this is Impact, the Shoujo Wonder manga, that's a completely different style. Anyway, so, this book, let's go. So this section is about how to draw the chip in the chibi style. It's a really, really cute because of course it is, how to draw in the chibi style, which is really, really cute. Essentially it's playing with, it's basically radically simplifying, proportions to the point that if you've noticed before, like, were several heads high, now it's just literally three. And the way that they're drawing it is like, oh, this is one, two, three, that's how many heads high it is. Then you draw the features, which are very, very simple. And then draw the limbs, which are very, very short. But, if you've noticed, it's still proportional to the rest of the body. So, if you notice that, like, even though they're, like, super deformed, which is what the, style is called, the chibi style is also called SD style, or super deformed style. Arms and legs are basically around the same, proportionally, the same in terms of, like, half the body, like, three quarters of the way down from the top. Ooh, my goodness. Oh, you know what? It's time for the first slurp stream. Ooh. Thank you. It's important to stay hydrated, even and especially when you're doing any sort of creative work. It's quite literally how your brain gets connected to all the ideas. Something about what's it called? Neuroplasticity and the amount of water and hydration, blah 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 blah. It's important. That's all I'm gonna say. So essentially there's even levels of what's it called, chibi variations. For example, this is like if you've ever seen like a very moe character like Yotsuba from Yotsuba and or Yotsuba ampersand exclamation point, that is basically the chibi version of that. Moderate chibi is like the more chibi that you kind of see in anime and manga, but the super super chibi stuff is more like you know those Nendoroid toys from the Good Smile Company or Funko Pops. That's probably the best, better cultural touchstone for most of the folks in the West would be the Funko Pop levels of chibi. I really don't like Funko Pops. I'm sorry. I find them really, really scary and kind of like they really cross into the uncanny valley feeling type thing where it's just the dead-eyed stare is just not cool for me. I do not like it. I am sorry. I'm sorry for anyone who likes Funko Pops, especially some of my actual friends. Hopefully they don't watch this. Anyway, and much in the same way that the proportions are simplified in various chibi, various super deformable chibi styles, you can also like very simplify their like emotions using instead of actually showing someone's face lined in anger by like showing the lines like this, showing like their face is scrunched up and like the wrinkles form in their head and like their face kind of squishes up a little bit when they're angry, you can just draw like yep on their face and then boom, they're angry, or tears literally coming out of their eyes. It doesn't actually look like that, obviously, and if your eyeballs are literally melting out of your skull much like this tearful fellow, please seek help. That is not actually what's supposed to happen to you. Can I zoom this in? Oh yes I can, hold on. Oop. I don't know why I didn't do this earlier. There we go. Embarrassed. Kurawa Hasagashi desu. Hasugashi? Something like that. Despondent is a new one. I was gonna think this is just like crybaby. Bored is a funny one. Frustrated feels like a more like complex emotion than this. Surprised, not very. Devious. So my issue with a devious one kind of makes him look like he's irritated as opposed to scheming. There's probably a better way to do that. Vulnerable or unsure kind of looks more like they're looking up to somebody, and upset doesn't look so upset, but again, this is all up to interpretation. It's still very, very cute. Anyway, for today's session, I think we're gonna try creating our own chibi, or rather drawing our own chibi. And first I'm going to transition to this guy. Through a specific character, and I'm not going to give you the name of the character quite yet. Because Kurawa Himitsu desu, and I kind of want to see if anyone can guess who this character is via how I'm drawing them. And all that. I will be taking inspiration not just from the official art, but also from like fan art from others on, well, fan art from others, and that should immediately give you a clue of who this person I might be drawing, who this person is. Hold on. I'm going to keep the lesson up in a separate window. Okay, so, you must, forgive me for being a little, like, stop and go. I'm still trying to get used to this, entire setup. And specifically because, I am working with a, graphics tablet instead of my usual pen display. And not just that, the size of the screen that I'm using for this graphics tablet is like the 21 inch very big screen instead of my usual this 24 inch? This is a 24 inch screen, yeah. The 21 inch screen is probably going to be a little smaller. And it's about the size of like how many of like it's just the proportions are a little weird, and so the way I it's hard to parse. Anyway. Right, we're gonna we're still gonna be the same place, and I'm gonna draw with their color, actually. Go with a light blue. Okay. So, the first thing that asks of the okay, I'm just gonna do this my way. Hold on. Oh man, dang it. Hold on. I don't know why, but I can draw straight lines much better if they're at an angle. But anyway, so the first step is essentially to build the frame. And the frame is, if you've noticed, oh, come on. Hold on, technical difficulties. Really? Okay, so the stand I'm using is literally the stand I have at home, rather literally the stand I use at home for my pen display, and like the rubber at the bottom is basically rubbed away because they're like literal tiny flecks of rubber, and so I've replaced them with like things that people put on their furniture to stop it from bashing against the wall, available in Home Depot for like $7, and there's like a whole bunch more. Anyway. I'm just putting this here. There we go. Now I can really lean on this thing. Alright, there we go. Nice. Okay. The first thing is to build the frame. I'm gonna add something here. This is kind of an easy way to build a more realistic head size for there we go. There we go. That's a really easy way of, like, if you draw a circle on the side of the head, that's kind of, and like, you kind of, it's like the, what's his name? Loomis version of creating, easy way of creating skulls, because if you imagine your skull is a ball, and you cut off the sides of the ball, that's kind of like the flat shape of your skull, and it basically very easily places your ears. Or people's ears right there, which is nice. Alright, we're gonna soften that cheek up a little bit. And what I want, zoom in. So, the one thing digital has over paper is the fact that you really can't zoom in on paper unless you mash your face against, like, your sketchbook. which is funny, but otherwise not very efficient. Alright, so that's the first step. The next step is to outline the features and kind of build them up a bit. Now we're working really close here, so A, I can show you, and B, so it's easier for me to create these lines using my arm instead of like little tiny strokes. It's best to like follow the curve of the circle, even though it's a little imperfect, quite frankly. Alright, so the next step. Okay, the next step is to basically draw their kind of draw their eyeballs. I'm gonna have them like actually looking at the audience instead of looking out in the distance. Now, eyeballs and pupils are not supposed to be this big. There's an amazing horror manga called Frankenfran that kind of stipulates that this young girl wants to be an idol and so kind of wants to go the full chibi, huge eyes, huge head, tiny mouth, type of anime types thing. The problem is it kind of causes her hair to fall out and like she literally becomes like an alien when you look at her from a bad angle, because that's what like the chibi thing actually looks like, structurally speaking, if you like actually build them in a real human, and it's terrifying and weirdly funny because this is Frankenfran after all, which is like a comedy horror manga, which is a lot more common than you may think. I think we made the head a little bit too thick. We can fix that. Beep beep. Beep beep. There we go. Alright, so this one they have dress on. Let's see if they put the body. Now, I'm just gonna outline the body, or a body, or a torso here. So it can kinda have a frame for, whatever clothes I want them to wear. And I'm gonna kinda skip a step. And just draw their... I just draw their legs. So keep in mind, whenever you're doing this big head type thing, remember that the feet usually end at the heel, and then the rest of the foot is actually underneath that, just like this one. Right. So this is going to be covered by clothes anyway. So ignore the weirdly shaped body. I'm gonna move this a little bit. Oop. The other thing I miss when I'm drawing here in the branch is I really want... I miss my chair. I have a really nice office chair that has a really wide butt, because I have a really wide butt. And it's really soft to sit in, and I can sit on it for hours because it's one of those ergonomic chairs that's like made for sitting in. Let's see. How am I gonna draw her? Alright, so obviously the hand is like... Alright, so here's a thing that's really easy to realize about hands. If I do this, you can actually see, even though my face is covered, that your hand is about as big as your face. Or, like, if you look at it, it's maybe half, but otherwise it does cover your face. Obviously, if you were chibi-sized, that's impossible, considering how gigantic chibi faces are. But even here, when we were trying to do this as, like, accurately proportionally as possible, you notice that the face is proportional to the size of the hand. A head. So rather, the head is disproportional to the size of the hand. And don't forget that even in chibi form, the arms are connected to, the back of the arms are connected to the, like, this part. Like, the shoulder blades and also the front blades are connected. This is like a triangle. And that's, it's nice to remember that, in drawing, so that it's kind of lends itself to some sense of realism. Anywho. I'm kind of making them like oddly muscular, but that's only because like of the proportions and how that works out. Let's see. All right, so we're basically skipping all the instructions at this point because we've already added the arms and the legs, and at this point, for hairs and eyes and fine tune, we're already at the fine tuning section. Anyway. So we're gonna draw their essentially a very significant part of their outfit, which is their hoodie. Wow, this went too close. Also, the one thing that digital artists have that traditional artists don't have is an undo button, which has saved my butt more times than I care to admit and care to count. And like a eraser. And like a few fun erasers. Puts it under her. Okay, this is definitely giving away who this person is. If anyone recognizes their, what's it called? Very iconic hoodie, then no prizes for you to for guessing who I'm drawing. Okay. Do they have pants? I don't think they have pants. No, they don't have pants. Rather, I think the hoodie goes all the way down to like their, like down here. Let me go ahead and make those changes then. Oh no. Oh no. Also, they just have like sneakers. Sneakers are simultaneously the easiest and hardest thing to draw when it comes to footwear. They're easy because they're really just, you know, sneakers, but they're hard because they're what's it called? They're hard because like. Some sneakers, like, you can just draw sneakers, but some of them really do have, like, these fancy, attachments to them that kind of keep them away from being just, like, a total sneaker. Rather, a regular sneaker. Which is fun, no doubt about that, but, like, at the same time, it can be a little tedious. Go ahead and slim her legs down, because good golly molly, like the other legs kind of make her look like an Amazon. Not in a bad way, just in a very specific way. Like, whoever designed this person's character, rather this character specifically, is, like, A, a fantastic designer, and B, probably really has this character's design down to a T. It's very cute. It's very cute despite, like, you know, he's a shark. So I think this is enough for the dress, or rather the hoodie. Just give it a couple wrinkles here, just to show that it's actually on a body and not just hanging off of, you know, a store rack. Who am I listening to? Is this? I think I know who this is. I think this is Cassiopeia? Is this Cassiopeia? No, I have no idea who this is. Still, very funky, very solid beat. I very much like it. Should be bigger. Alright, now we do her hair. Which would be a little more... Well, actually it should be relatively simple. But there's just a lot of stuff in the way. Like, there's a part here that goes all the way down. And there's a little pigtail part here, and also kind of goes down. Oh, so no, this is the long hair version. Erase the ears, because you don't need ears. The bangs. Yeah, definitely her drew her hair wrong. I think her hair is like shorter. I think one of the art over it. Yeah, no, it's supposed to be short. Oh well. It's fine. So this is supposed to be Gorgora. Or at least the very sketchy version of her, as we can see here. Oh, dang. Okay. Let's see. That is about... That's about... I don't want to say that's about it, but rather that's basically... That's basically it in terms of, like, the chibi lesson. Let me very quickly check to make sure... Anyway, so, essentially, we've basically gone through, like, the three heads high, moderate chibi version of how to... Hold on. I am speaking to... There we go. So, we've basically gone over, like, the three chibi heads high version of this character. And that's basically how to do it. One of the hallmarks of... anime has always been like how to make stuff that looks like this, and it's very, very cute and very, very fun. That said, I think that's about time in terms of how much time we have left for this lesson, or rather this session, or this lesson. Right, so just as one last thing. So, as I mentioned before, this is the Manga Drawing Lessons from the Govan's branch of the Enoch Preffery Library. You can pick up all the take and make stuff here in this branch while supplies last, of course. And the lessons are going to be here. And I think it's on tinyurl.com/ Manga Drawing Lessons. Manga Drawing Lessons Weekly or Manga Drawing Lessons. Yeah. Either way, the address is right here. Anyway. The next lesson, we're going to continue on with the more complex stuff, which is going to be fun. I think I'm going to be at my workstation at home. So, quality maybe more or less, we're just going to be a little different. I'm definitely going to need to figure out how to remake this version of here, since I don't have a camera at home, unfortunately. Either way, alright. We're going to go ahead and call it a day. We really do appreciate you taking your time and day to go through and watch this lesson. I hope that I've made this fun, or made this interesting at least, because that's the one thing I really want to implore here. This is like a great activity and I highly recommend it to everyone. Anyway, in any case, this has been Paolo Jassa at the Goffins Branch, the Enoch Preffery Library, calling it a day, and we'll see you next week.